Sam Phillips had a commercial sensibility, and I'm sure it must have dawned on him that if a white person were singing this music, he would get an audience for it.
Sam Phillips kept up a steady stream of blues releases with the likes of B.B. King, Bobby Blue Bland, and Junior Parker until 1954, when he struck gold with a white boy, singing an Arthur Crudup blues track.
Well, that's all right, Mama. That's all right for you. That's all right, Mama. Just any way you do, that's all right.
Things changed when Elvis Presley walked through that door. To me, Elvis hits eternity with the first record, That's All Right, Mama. Elvis took that black art and embraced it and sang it to a wide audience and became a portal through which white people could experience black culture.
He snuck across an invisible racial barrier. All these rhythms got smuggled in this very attractive young man. And once he unleashed that, there was no putting that back in the box and putting the lid on it and locking it back up.
A tectonic shift was stirring in American pop culture. Musical and racial categories were becoming redundant. Blues and country, black and white, were all morphing into a brand new sound, rock and roll. So when an aspiring blues performer, Chuck Berry, walked into Chess Records with a cover of a country song, Leonard Chess's eyes lit up.
My father and my uncle always had that ear for something different. And as soon as they heard that Ida Red song, they told him, change the lyric, come back.
Maybelline, why can't you be true? Oh, Maybelline, can't you be true? You started back doing
I remember hearing Maybelline when it came out on the radio. It struck me as like, that's a hillbilly song. Chuck Berry's a black guy doing a hillbilly song. This is cool.
When I first heard Chuck Berry, I thought he was a white person. All my friends thought he was white, and all the girls thought he was white, too.
It changed everything in Chuck. We never had a record like that, a crossover hit. We never sold records to white people before. I mean, this was a big change.
People were hearing Chuck Berry records and thought they were hearing a white person. And people were hearing Elvis Presley records and thought they were hearing a black person.
Oh,
rock and roll was